Hi everyone, I'm Ariana. Welcome to my channel. As I have mentioned a few times before in previous videos, the best and safest place for you to mint your NFTs is in your own smart contract or collection. Today, we have many tools that allow you to create one with zero code. No need for any programming skills. I've already showed you how to deploy your Ethereum smart contract on Manifold. And now, I'm gonna show you how to do it on Foundation. Foundation is one of the top NFT marketplaces. It was initially a kind of curated platform, meaning you had to know another artist already on the platform to be accepted. Since May 2022, they opened their doors to all creators and have been releasing some pretty cool features. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create your own Ethereum smart contract or collection, mint NFTs in it, and put them up for sale on Foundation. Now let's get into it. So the first step is to access Foundation's website, which is foundation.app, and connect your wallet. After connecting our wallet, now to create a collection, we have to click here on Create. And then we're gonna click on collections in the sidebar. You can see that there are other options here like mint and drop. I'll probably make a next video going a little bit more in depth into these options too. But let's just select collections. Now here we'll have to include the collection name, which is the title and basically the identity of our collection and the NFTs that we're going to be minting in it. And the collection symbol, which is a symbol that acts as a token name on the blockchain for this collection's NFTs. So you know, in cryptocurrency, we have the name of the crypto and also its symbol, like Bitcoin, its symbol is BTC, and Ethereum, its symbol is ETH or ETH. So it's the same thing with our collection or our smart contract. So we have to create a symbol that will represent that collection of tokens. All these details are recorded on the blockchain and will represent our work. So make sure to double check that they're correct and free of errors, because we won't be able to change these details later on. Now, if everything is correct, just click on Continue. And sign the transaction that is going to appear in the wallet. This will require paying gas fees. After doing that, your contract will be deployed and will be on the blockchain. So now that our contract is deployed, we can go to the collection page and we can start customizing it. So we'll click on Edit Collection and we'll be able to add a logo, a banner, and a description to our collection. So this is what I'm gonna do now. Okay, so now we are ready to mint an NFT to our collection. So to do that, on the collection page, we'll click on plus mint NFT and we'll be able to upload the NFT file. So just a quick note, NFT assets uploaded to Foundation are kept on IPFS, which is a peer-to-peer data storage system. I've already talked about the importance of using IPFS to store NFT files, so make sure to check it out. I'll leave a link to this video in the description below. Now, after uploading our file, we'll be able to add the NFT's title and description. And here we can also create a split in case we want to split the fee or the royalties with someone else that also worked on this NFT. Now, it's important to make sure that everything is correct before minting, because these details will be recorded on the blockchain, and again, we won't be able to change them later. Now, click on Preview, and we'll be able to review our NFT's assets and its details. After doing that, click Mint NFT, and again, sign the transaction in the wallet. This process will also require paying gas fees to complete the transaction. Now, after doing that, it's time to list our NFTs. We have to click on Sell NFT and we'll be directed to the List for Sale page. You'll be able to choose between Buy Now, where you can quickly set a price and the NFT can be instantly sold, and a Live Auction, where we have to set a reserve price. In this case, I'm gonna click Buy Now and I'm gonna enter the Buy Now price. Note that Foundation charges a 5% sale fee, so we'll actually receive a little less than the set price once that NFT is sold. And now, set price. So once again, we have to confirm the transaction in a wallet and pay the required gas fees to complete this transaction and set our price. So now our NFT is listed and ready to be sold. So once again, I just want to remind you that every time that you interact with the Ethereum blockchain, you will be required to pay gas fees. So just make sure you have enough ETH in your wallet to pay the gas fees and make sure that you can afford all these transactions. So here, the more NFTs that you mint, the more expensive it will get, because you will have to pay gas fees for each NFT that you are minting. So just bear in mind that it can become a little costly. So before we leave, if you find this tutorial useful, make sure to like it, comment below, and share it with your friends. Thanks again, everyone, for watching. And as always, I'll see you in the next video.